Okay, cool. So let's give a warm welcome to Nathan and Zach.
I don't think I've seen some of you guys before. Have you guys seen me before? I would like to start off, and you guys have questions before I go on about my in-law and how it impacted my life. So, three questions I really have for you.
Ryan.
There you go.
Just need a minute. Question number three. Have you ever had doubters? Ever had other things that you cannot do because of who you are? Have you ever had the motivation to prove people wrong? Have you ever been through it before? Okay. So if you know that I'm deaf, I can answer these questions myself. But don't have me.
Why does that keep happening?
Maybe I need to sit closer.
That was a joke.
See what I mean?
I think it's your phone.
Oh, I can answer these questions myself. I have gone through so many stages in my life with people telling me that I cannot do things because I'm deaf, and I have so many doubters in my life. With these doubters, I had the motivation my entire life to prove people wrong in many different ways. I have been living my life the hard way. You will find out the true meaning of the hard way, and I'm here tonight to talk about my deafness, the past challenges in my life, and future challenges for the rest of my life. My hearing loss has truly impacted my life in many different ways. As some of you may have watched, and I use football on TV, or maybe have gone through football game, and I use the hard way on a lot of your football helmets. It is a trademark at NIU that defines the history of the football team. Overcome so many obstacles, and it is so difficult to go through these obstacles, and they get themselves on the right national exposure without giving up and believing in each other. And then you have a culture of proving doubters wrong. And with proving these doubters wrong, I feel very related to that trademark, the hard way, because it became a personal meaning to me because I don't give up. I prove doubters wrong, just like that football team does. So I lived my life the hard way by believing in myself while growing up, overcoming so many difficult obstacles, and proving a lot of doubters wrong without giving up. I was born on February 19, 1982, in Rockford, Illinois, with an auditory nerve loss. My hearing loss wasn't discovered until a later time. My mom suspected that I was not hearing anything for a while. I was 18 months old. She did it at home experiment to figure out if I'm not hearing anything or if I'm hearing anything. She grabbed a kitchen pan and stood behind me, banging the pan as loud as she could to see if I could hear the pan or not. I was not responding to pan being. The experiment showed my parents that I am truly deaf. I went to the audiologist and had some hearing tests done. The results that that I'm deaf. I began wearing hearing right away at 18 months old. Putting me hearing down for the first time was a resolution to my hearing problem, as I was at a beginning of a long way to go with my deafness and the challenges that I would be facing for the rest of my life doing the hard way. At the time hearing aids were put on, I did not respond to the sound coming in my ears because I didn't know how to respond. It took a few years for me to learn how to finally respond and react to the sound. For a while, if someone was calling my name to get my attention, I didn't know how to react to the name calling. In other words, it was like sound coming into this ear, going through me and out. While discovering the hearing loss at 18 months old, I had to learn English, sign language at the same time, because I was not speaking at all. According to my mom, it took a few years to finally learn how to listen to the sound and be able to react from the sound. I began talking at 3.5 years old after a preschool teacher said that I would never ever speak in my life. From that time, when I started talking until the end of junior high, I attended speech therapy 2 to 3 days a week. There were so many ups and downs in speech therapy. The hardest thing for me in speech therapy were pronouncing words that butter end with the letter at or at. I also had a hard time pronouncing things that had a TH or a SH at the end of the word. While developing language, sign language, and speech therapy, I attended preschool with other deaf kids going through a similar situation that I was going through. The preschool classes had a teacher and a teacher's aide that used sign language to be able to communicate and teach us. Throughout the elementary school years, I attended deaf classes with a deaf classmate where the teacher signed and educated us. It was a pretty slow learning class where it took a longer time to develop language and other subjects. As I reached junior high school, I started to mainstream where all my classes were with teachers and students that did not sign language, but the class required sign language interpreters to be there. For example, I had to take gym classes, art classes, with the sign language interpreter there. I continued to take some deaf classes when it came to English, algebra, history, science, those general classes. These deaf classes were still slow learning, and I was sort of behind on vocabulary and English. While attending junior high school, I was starting to understand what I was going through in my life with my hearing. I realized that I had been labeling myself as hard of hearing instead of a deaf person. One day in junior high school, a teacher was introducing me to a student teacher and said that I was a deaf student. It became so bothersome to me in my mind that I did not like to be called deaf. While I saw a different former teacher one day, I told her about it. She said that the teacher was more focused on my audiogram than who I am and then the thing, well, why you win? That's what comes out when you have your hearing test done. So all of my audiogram said that every single hearing test that I am deaf. However, I truly do not function like a deaf person. I truly function like a hard of hearing person. In other words, deaf more often comes to the definition of mute and no ability to speak, vocalize. The word hard of hearing more often comes to the definition of the ability to speak and hear other half of the name while not being able to hear some of the things. I confronted the teacher and I asked her, please do not label me as deaf. Please label me as part of him. She did not like my vision. Oh, we compromised and we agreed that I would be labeled as anything for the time being. I went into high school and I began the first 2 years taking some deaf classes and some mainstream classes. Similar to what I did in junior high. Then I needed to get myself prepared for college coming up. And I completely mainstream out in every single class for the rest of my high school years. It was a huge challenge for me because I was still behind on language and vocabulary. However, I was very fortunate to get some extra help with some teachers after school. I defeated high school with a high school diploma. Toward the end of my high school years, I had two deaf teachers point out that I would not be successful in college and I would not be able to graduate because of who I am and the long language and the low vocabulary I had. It was so honorable to me for teachers to be like that, to be so negative on me and not have even faith in my future. Their comment became so personal to me. Because this happened to me, it became a huge motivational tool for me and a constant reminder in the back of my head that I established a personal goal of mine besides the primary goal of getting a college degree. My personal goal was to prove the teacher wrong. I feel like I had to show them that I could be capable of doing anything and to graduate with a college degree. I was on a mission of my personal goal doing the hard way. College was very challenging for me, especially studying at Rock Valley College, which is a community college in Rockford. It took me longer to finish out community college than I started taking below 101 level classes. I took tutoring sections for a lot of classes in community college. All of my classes had note takers and a sign language interpreter that were provided through the community college. I was very active working through the student newspaper at Rock Valley College. I was a sports writer, sports editor, managing editor, and editor at all the time at college. There were people across the college campus saying that the student newspaper would never be successful in winning the state among junior colleges because a deaf guy is running the newspaper. It turned out that my newspaper would rank first in the state in overall affluence and layout during my time as an editor-in-chief. It was a great feeling to prove these people wrong, and I was doing it the hard way. It took me 4 hard-working years to finally graduate with a college degree and an associate in art degree at Rock Valley College. I knew I could graduate college, but I felt like I needed to prove these high school teachers wrong by doing more. I wanted to continue doing the hard way. I wanted to make my lifelong dream come true by attending Northern Illinois University in DeKalb. Going to NIU was the best life experience that I had ever gone through. I love NIU with all my heart. The university means so much to me. Everyone was so good to me at NIU, meeting all my needs of an interpreter, a note taker, and whatever thing I needed to become successful in college. I became the vice president for Deaf Pride, which is a student orientation promoting deaf awareness and deaf culture across NIU and the community of DeKalb. I also serve on a student with disability advisory board at NIU to improve accessibility across the university campus. I graduated NIU after 2.5 years of being there with a bachelor's of arts degree in art. It was the icing on the cake that now I have two college degrees under my name, that I succeeded my personal goal of proving the high school teacher wrong. Once again, two college degrees, which is the biggest reason why I relate myself to the hard way slogan that NIU had. And I currently serve myself with pride, having two college degrees under my name. I continue to carry myself through the hard way through the working world. During the 10 summer years as a high schooler and a college student, I worked at Magic Water Park in Rockford. I was doing groundskeeping and maintenance. A supervisor told me that I worked so hard on the job all the time, and I deserved to get promoted, and I will never be promoted because I cannot function on a radio walkie-talkie. Being told like that was not right to me. I spoke with the higher-up supervisor about the comments that were told to me, and that I also strongly believe that I deserved to be promoted whether I had a hearing loss or not. They were so furious to have this happen, and they corrected the issue for me, and they have made several accommodations for me in order for me to become a supervisor without me to have a radio walkie-talkie involved on the job. The last 4 or 5 years on the job went through and worked out so well. After being laid off at a factory job in Rockford, I had many different job interviews across the Chicagoland area, and I would turn down so many positions. A lot of warehouse jobs did not want to hire me for a lot of different reasons. Like, one reason could be stinky reasons, because the forklift moving around, why don't you travel around forklift? And I felt like it was not fair to me to not be given a chance for a year and a half looking for a job. And I had no doubt for a year and a half. But thanks to a very special family friend of mine, she got me a job to work at the company that I am at right now. She had me spot out at a temporary position, and then I moved over to a different department for the long-term permanent basis. As I am now working in my current position, I am now a telepathic product supervisor at our Solution International, which is an engine company in Wooddale and I capture. I have been with the company for 9 years now. The company has been so good to me and have made so many accommodations for me. I work in an electronics lab with 5 different computers, and I have doors locked and closed. I have people knocking on my door. Don't mind, I do not hear the knocks on my door. Well, I've been given a doorbell outside my office when someone wants to see me or come in. Oh, and I also heavily do face-to-face communication, email, and text messaging to be able to communicate with my coworkers and customers. I have a very funny story to tell you that happened to me 12 years ago. It's okay to laugh now because I think it's funny now. And I have told so many people about this story. One morning, my best friend and I, we were in McDonald's in line to order our food. We were communicating and dining. My best friend, completely deaf, cannot hear, cannot vocalize, so we find each other. So when we got to the register, he and I were given a braille menu, which is a menu for blind people. We were so confused. We told the lady at the register, we can see, but we cannot hear. My best friend was pointing at me, saying, Nathan's got glasses, he can see. People lying behind us were laughing so hard, and they just couldn't believe what they just thought. So after what happened, my best friend and I were just looking at each other and saying, wow, what did just happen? We just couldn't believe it. So my best friend was just texting his other deaf friend, just told him what happened. He happened to them too. We were just so shocked because it never happened to us before. So, moving forward, I strongly believe that businesses out there, retail, restaurants, anything, I believe that these businesses need to know how to interact with people with special needs, handicapped, deaf, blind, and when I worked at the water park, they had a mandatory training for all the employees on how to interact with special needs people. I was very grateful to be a part of that when I worked at the water park. I married my wife, Carrie, about almost 10 years ago, and she did not have a hearing loss at all. I have been often asked, what is it like to be married to someone with no hearing loss? There have been times when a lot of things have been misheard or misunderstood. We often work it out by talking it out, going after people anymore. Other times, at night time, in the middle of the night, she needs to wake me up. She's trying to talk to me. And I'm like, I can't see you, I can't hear you, because my hearing aids are off, my glasses are off. I don't know what you're saying to me. Because I can't read her lips. And then, my daughter, Laura, was born almost 6 years ago, and everybody had a big question. If Nora would have a hearing loss or not. After Nora took the hearing test, we found out that she did not have a hearing loss. I became very emotional with tears going out of my eyes. I was so relieved because I did not want her to be going through the things that I've gone through in my life. Even though it wasn't a big deal to other people, people asked me why I was so emotional about it. I told them that they have no idea to vent my emotions in this situation because they have no experience of having a hearing loss. I have been often asked how well I hear with my hearing on and without my hearing. With the hearing aid on, I hear about 80 to 85% of the things. Without the hearing aid, I hear absolutely nothing. I cannot hear my voice without the hearing aid. I feel like there's two different sides of me. Like one side of me being completely deaf without the hearing aid on, and one other side of me being hard of hearing with the hearing aid on. I wore my first hearing aid for about 16 years, and then I was introduced to some well-fan hearing aids shortly after I started college. These new hearing aids were digital hearing aids. The nice thing about those digital hearing aids we are seeing out there today have the ability to do many different things compared to the first hearing aids that I wore 18 months ago. These digital hearing aids have a hearing comfort level bar. I'm going to show you this. You see the hearing level bar. That day, loud noises. And then quiet time. Now, we have the comfort level. When there's, you know how when you hear something so loud, you're like, well, now with the hearing aid, it brings the loud down to comfort level, where it's not like, and then anything that goes quiet, the hearing aid brings up the comfort level where I can be able to hear it. So that's where my hearing aid go right now. So, with the hearing aid, I have heard of sound that I had never heard of before, because of what this is doing. The digital hearing picked up sound that my older hearing aid was not able to pick up. I heard water running for the first time. I heard birds and crickets chirping. I heard air blowing out of the air tank. I heard fans blowing. Hearing these things were so amazing to hear. Afterwards, when I got another new set of hearing aids about 3 years ago, it improved communication for me, especially with people with foreign accents. I was able to hear and comprehend better the foreign accent in order for me to communicate better with these people, especially with Mexican and Polish people I work. I still have to heavily rely on face-to-face communication to relive. And this is how I grew up, and it will remain like this for the rest of my life. If someone looked at me the other way, I wouldn't be able to understand what people are saying. Or like if you're walking away, I don't know. And overall, face-to-face is important to me. And for example, if you turn the radio on, I can hear the music, but I don't know what they're saying because I rely on lip reading. And same thing with the telephone. I can hear the phone, and it's more like, well, I don't know what they're saying, but I do hear what they're saying. And because I need to do technology has improved so much for me on many different options of ways to communicate with people, which is text messaging, email, Facebook, FaceTime, and of course the non-technology way of fake community. While watching movies or TV, I heavily rely on broadcasting subtitles in order to understand what is being said. The cool part is the movie theaters are now starting to provide closed captioning to any kind of movie you want to see. The movie theater provides a device shaped like a rearview mirror, and if you put it in your cup holder, and it's right in front of your face while you look at the movie screen. And you can even adjust it if you want. I was so happy that they're starting to do this. As a matter of fact, it's starting to become an Illinois state law that every movie theater needs to do this. I have been going to the movies a lot more than I ever had. Many people have often asked me, how do you wake up in the morning? I have a flat round light that is plugged in my alarm clock, in my pillowcase, and vibrates. It is so hard to endure the vibration unless you want to hit the snooze button to sleep a little bit longer. I never had an alarm clock until junior high school. Previously, my mother had to wake me up in the morning before that. While growing up as a kid, I hated going to church because I had no bilingual interpreter. I did pretty much that in the worship service, not be able to understand anything. I attended Sunday school for the first 2 years. I hated it because I was not able to understand anything. I stopped going to Sunday school. I had gone to confirmation. I did not understand anything as I just sat there. It was no fun for me at all. I pretty much stopped going to church after high school. I had gone through a couple Christian non-denominational interpret worship services during college, and I really enjoyed it. I stopped going to church again when I was in a long-distance relationship with my girlfriend, who is now my wife, because I often come to the Schaumburg area to be with her on the weekend. My wife and I, we got married at a Lutheran church in Arlington Heights. I loved the fact that I had an interpreter on my wife. For the first several years, my wife and I, we argued so much that we should go to church more often. I told her I did not even like going to church because I would just sit there not understanding anything. When a pastor throws in a small joke, I would just sit there and watch everyone laugh, and I don't know what they're doing. It bothered me so much not to be able to laugh along with everyone else. There have been a few Sundays when I'm just grumpy and I take it out on Terry because I was so depressed, getting at church, not understanding anything. When my daughter Nora was going to be baptized, my family friend had set up and paid for an interpreter to come to the baptism. When I first met the interpreter, she began coming to my church to interpret once a month. It became a brand new deaf ministry at that church. And then now, 2 years ago, my family and I, we transferred here from the city. 2 years ago, I had a strong vision of having a deaf ministry here in Princeton. I approached Pastor Helstead about having a deaf ministry here. He was willing to start one here. The interpreter at the previous church followed me. She now interprets print piece two times a month. I no longer hate going to church now because I have the resources I need. I have a study with the church, the deaf ministry, and we have the deaf people come where I can worship them. I am what happier on Sunday now because I love going to church. Ever since I started attending here, I have helped the church become a much more accessible church for the deaf people to attend. The church has a strong desire to bring more deaf people to ministry. This church continues to amaze me with the great support that I get from our pastors, the church council, the congregation, and the community. I love my church family and all of you with my husband. As I have grown up deaf through the hard way, my life will continue ahead with future challenges and obstacles. I am on a mission to provide deaf awareness and educate people out there with my personal deaf story that I just shared with you tonight. My mission is to show that deaf people can do anything but hear, and they do it the hard way. My deafness keeps my life going because I continue to prove people wrong. I continue to overcome challenges, and I continue not to give up. I will not allow anyone to tell me no because of my deafness. And I'm going to find ways to work around the no answer by compromising. I'm a strong believer in myself, and I strongly believe that God keeps me going, and that's how I will continue the hard way the rest of my life. Thank you.